Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to another week of Open Cluster Management Community Meetings. Today is October 11, 2024. On the agenda today, Kishin's going to walk us through the very exciting next release of OCMIO 0.15. Kishin, please take it away whenever you're ready. Thank you.
Okay, let me share my screen. Yeah, okay, so I think it's time for another OCM release. It's been like 3 months, since 3 or 4 months since the last release. And we've made several good progress on that. This is a board that I list here for the main features in the 15. So I think the main thing that we already did is about the Helm chart part, the provide Helm chart for the OCM components. So we have, thanks for Zhiwei, that we have built a Helm chart for the cluster manager and class lead in the OCM repo. And we basically can start installing OCM control plane and agent using the Helm chart. We already did in the class ADM. We also refactor in this Epic. We also refactor the class ADM tool, so they will not maintain the manifest in their code, the duplicate installation manifest in the class ADM code. Well, they will just reference the Helm chart in the OCM repo. So this is one thing that we have already done. And another is the Google Scholarship that has been successfully completed. We do have some thing that has been committed onto the Python Country repo about to collect the GPU resource and give the add-on placement score that has been implemented in the add-on country repo. And we also have some solution part we have a solution that is to integrate queue with OCM, so you can use the multi-queue features in a queue project to schedule the AI workload using the placement scheduling mechanism in the OCM to schedule the workload. There is some other things, like the add-on is, we changed the add-on framework. So currently we have the add-on generic add-on manager installed in the control plane, and all the add-on is default to be managed by the add-on manager. You still can use that add-on to manage by itself, but by default, in starting from this release, all the add-on will be managed by add-on manager, which means that the add-on manager will be responsible for rolling out upgrade all the add-on when something is changed in the add-on configuration. For example, when the version of the add-on is changed, the generic add-on manager will help to rolling out the add-ons based on the rolling out policy defined in the cluster management add-on resource. So, and I think that has been done, but Haoqing, would you like to confirm whether any else still mean?
So currently, if you use the latest add-on framework, it will be default. The add-on will be default managed by add-on manager. Well, if your user is still using the previous version, 0.9, they are still managed by self. I think this topic, this issue is I have some more things to do for the next step is totally remove the managed by itself and let the add-on default managed by add-on manager. So we still have some tasks to do for this issue, I think.
Maybe do you think that we can create another one for removal? And because based on this,
Oh, let me check. I think this issue is originally for the removal. I'm not
okay.
sure about the mode to in progress. It not started yet, I think.
Got it. And class API integration. So we do have some class API integration in the class ADM that you can use the class ADM to import a class API provision cluster to the OCM. So we also I think we also have another issue, but they don't be finished in this release, that is to automatically to have a controller, centralized controller in the control plane that can automatically install the agent to the class API provision cluster. And since that is that is based on that depends on the Helm chart part. So after we have since we have finished the Helm chart implementation since OCM components in this release, we should be able to in the future release to finish the part that you can have a centralized way to automatic in to import a cluster provisioned cluster to the OCM. Another one is about adopting the class inventory API into this from the SIG multi-cluster. So we have a in-flight PR. We still have in-flight PR. I will take a look at this one, and if anyone is interested, please take a look at it also. I hope we can make it in this release. And this is also gated by the feature gate, so you have to enable the feature gate to install the class inventory API. And after that, there will be a sync logic between the managed cluster in OCM and class inventory API. We will sync things like properties, conditions, etc., from the managed cluster to the class inventory API. This will be the first step that we integrate with class inventory in the SIG multi-cluster. And also, I think there is some work that has been done by Xuezhao around the hub, switching the hub. I need to check the issues, whether it's in the backlog or not tagged correctly for the release. But we also have introduced a feature that you can specify multiple bootstrap kube configs in the classlet, pointing to the different hub, multiple different hubs. So when one of the hub is done, or the user want the agent to switch to another hub, the user can specify that I don't want this hub to accept this cluster, and then the agent will automatically switch to another hub. So I will try to find the issue and put it here. So that's all this pretty everything that the main feature the That's pretty the main feature that we have been made in this release. And I want to check if any other thing that is missing, anything that we are still want to put into this release. Please let me know on the Slack or if there's nothing else, I will starting to we should starting to tag the each repo for the next for the 15 release 0.15 release. Any questions? performance.
Are there any questions and comments regarding the release for QGen? Well, QGen, it looks like a really exciting release. I mean, there's a lot of different features, especially the AI workload among the multiple clusters. I think that's gonna get a lot of attractions as well.
Yeah, I think so. And I think for another main big thing about the EKS integration, we won't be able to catch up in this release. I will double check with the devs in the guild where we did merge some API change on the classlet to support specifying using the AWS IRSA to for the registration, but the main logic in the registration has not been committed yet. So we for that part I will I think I might maybe we should double check with them and ensure they have a plan that align with us.
Yep, sounds good. I'll also reach out to them, see if there's anything that they need help on. Last we check is they're working on their own fork, so to speak.
Okay.
So hopefully they're still making some progress. And the API, yeah, like you said, the API changes were merged, so hopefully they're continuing with their implementation. But yeah, I'll double check with them as well. Thank you for reminding me. Is there any other things that you want to mention, QJang? I have some questions regarding the add-on template.
No, that's all for me.
Okay. So continuing the discussion from yesterday, so I'm developing the add-on for the Argo City agent. I got their agent installed on the hub and two managed clusters. And then we have the OCM installed on the hub and the managed clusters, so sitting right next to each other. So now the plan is to bundle the agent in the add-on template. But the agent components has two parts. One of them sits on the hub and the and their which is their essentially their server that the other client agents are communicate with. But when I read through the instruction on add-on templates, it just talks about these are the wrap manifests that are deployed to the managed clusters. But I need something that install on the hub as well. So what's your recommendation? How should I do it in this case? The hub installation I only need it once. So it's more like a it's not the manager, but it's part of the add-on as well. I only need it to install once, while the agent needs to be propagated to all the managed clusters.
So for the hub part component, is that there will be like for each agent you need to install one component or it's just one single
No,
component?
just once. Is there a principal server that all their other client agents will be communicating with?
I see. So I think the thing is you have, I think finally you need to put it those things into a single Helm chart, like the class management add-on, the add-on template, and the server deployment.
Got it.
Yes. I mean, if there are component doesn't install that server, we have to pull those as a customized package or in a single Helm chart.
Got it. And the server also requires like a certificate, and like to provide sometime a certificate to kind of facilitate that MTLS or communication between the their server and the clients, right? So when I install it in the first place, can I leverage anything in OCM? And I know yesterday you talked about how I can leverage the add-on for the agent side, but on the server side, on the hub side, I also need a certificate. So do I generate one? Can I use something that OCM IO provides, or what's your recommendation on that?
We don't provide anything today. It has to be generated. We have some kind of the code library that you can use that code to generate. Otherwise, there is maybe there's a way that if the thing is put in the Helm chart, and when you install in the Helm chart, the Helm can help to generate.
Okay, thank you. And then so
I think you also need the server to expose, right? It need some kind of a load balancer service or
yes.
Shift the root
yes
node port.
yes
yeah that will whether which way is you depends on the environment, so you need I think that's something that you need to also expose that at variables in the Helm chart to install.
Okay. And those are done via Helm chart without the assistance of OCM IO, right? Okay.
Yes.
So the part that I'm so it's all good. I got the cert in the Helm chart, and like you said, I need the load balancer to expose the servers on the hub side.
Yeah.
Now I have that cert that I generate, and now I need to essentially have the client side to use that cert to sign to do the MTLS. Can you talk a little bit about that again? How I can use the add-on template to do that? Because that cert it's like custom generated, right, from the Helm chart. So how can the OCM IO add-on template, what uses that cert to sign the client side to the client to server side connect?
Yeah, let me share my screen.
Okay, thank you.
So we have the add-on development guide here. So template
is on the far right, the
yeah here.
Okay.
Yes, so because we, for example, if you have generate a CA that is to be used for sign the client cert in the Helm chart, you will need to save that into a secret. And then for that secret, then in the add-on template, you need to specify a registration field. In the registration field, you cannot use kubectl, but use a custom signer. And the custom signer means you need to specify, the custom signer means that that will not generate a client server that connect to the kubeconfig, a kube API server, a hub kube API server, but can be any arbitrary endpoint that has already been already using MTLS. So this part is need to be put into the add-on template. The signer name can be anything in this format. There is something about a subject. This can be, if you don't, if there is nothing about the RBAC, it actually can be anything. Like you can specify a certain user, it will be mapped to the CN and the ON in the client cert. And then the most important is the signing CA. The signing CA is a CA that is going to be, that is going to sign the client cert finally on the hub side. So you need to specify the secret name that you have generated in the Helm chart. And then that's all. And with that, what happens is when the add-on is installed, the registration will create a CSR with this signer name. And then on the hub side, the add-on manager, the general add-on manager, is not the add-on manager for the single a separated add-on, but a common add-on manager will read this add-on template and he know that this is a certain signer. And then he will do some check. And then if all the check is passed, the add-on manager will approve that CSR. So when the CSR is approved, the registration agent, I mean, the registration agent is a class agent. The agent will find that the CSR is approved and then it will dump the client cert and client key into a secret. The secret has the secret has a certain name. It's the add-on name dash signer name dash client cert. So that will be in the install namespace of the add-on. So after the add-on is installed, it managed class add-on is created. Finally, there should be a secret in the managed secret created in the managed cluster and in the install namespace of the add-on. And then the secret name will be like this. And it will be mounted into the deployment with this mount pass. So this piece of YAML file doesn't need to be put into the deployment, into the agent manifest in the add-on template. So for example, if you have the add-on template writing like this, and there is nothing specify secret and volume mount. And if you have registration part with group client and customer signer, the add-on template controller will inject the volume mount. And so it will basically inject this piece of YAMLs, the volumes and the volume mounts into the deployment that is specified in the add-on template. So the only thing that add-on template need to do is, for example, in the add-on agent, you need to specify something like what is the client cert, what's a pass to get a client cert, and what's a pass to get a client key. And the only thing that the agent needs to do is to add in their arguments or the flags that this is a pass that I want to get a client cert and client key.
Yes, that is exactly what I needed. I know I exactly as you said, there's two arguments there in their agent startup container, and then yeah. I referenced the client cert and client key. The only missing thing is the user credential. I need to ask the Argo CD guys like what is that about? But yes, this is great. I mean if it all works out, this is exactly what I'm looking for. So thank you again, Qujiang. I'm sure I will have a lot more questions for you and Zhuzhang and whoever is the expert at the add-on template. But yeah, this this is exactly the information I'm looking for. Thank you very much, Kijan. Does anyone have any questions for Kijan? Or any question comments? I just want to give a shout out to Zhao Xu. Our new website's framework that's developed by Zhao Xu is now live and it's looking great. So thank you again, Zhao Xu, for all your hard work on the new website.
Thank you. No problem.
That's all I have. Thank you, everyone, for attending the this week's community meeting. See you in 2 weeks. Take care, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.